Hello, in this WAGO tutorial, we will show you how to configure an IEC-6870 master. In the video tutorial on the IEC-6870 slave, we used this overview image and described the configuration on the slave side. Now we will describe the configuration on the master side. A common application for WAGO telecontrol solutions is to connect other system components or devices to a PFC, which also communicate via telecontrol. The PFC continues to operate as a slave in the direction of the network operator, but then as a master in the direction of the connected peripherals. An important case is the connection of protection devices, for which IEC-6870 has its own communication protocol, Protocol 103, which we will discuss in more detail later in the video. In the telecontrol configurator, we select the IEC-6870-5 master tab. As with the slave, we can use the IEC-6870 master button to select the menu for selecting the communication protocol. In addition to the serial protocol 101, in the balanced or unbalanced options, and the Ethernet protocol 104, we also find the serial protocol 103 for protective devices. We start with the IEC-6870-5-104 protocol that communicates over the Ethernet interface. Most of the general settings have already been described in detail in the IEC-6870 slave tutorial. A link to the video can be found in the video description. There is an option to set an IV or NT bit when communication with a slave is lost, to mark the affected information objects as invalid or out of date. We can enter a comment in the slave communication settings. Then we enter the IP address and TCP port of the slave. For the link layer status, we set a bool variable that becomes true when communication is active. For disable link and disable IEC-104 link, we can specify variables that deactivate the communication with the slave. The difference between the two is that with disable link, the TCP connection is completely switched off. With disable IEC-104 link, the communication is set to passive by sending the stop DT telegram, and only the data transfer is deactivated, but test telegrams are still sent. This option is often used for redundant links. It allows the link to be switched to passive, but it is still monitored. The origin address of the master can be specified here. For time synchronization, we specify when the time synchronization object 103 should be sent. Disabled in the event that the slave synchronizes the time via an NTP server and does not require the object 103. Cyclically, for example, every 30 minutes. Once when the link is established, or altogether when link is established, and cyclically. The general interrogation trigger can also be set. In most cases, the master will trigger a general interrogation when the connection is established in order to have an up-to-date process image. During operation, the spontaneously or cyclically sent telegrams follow so that the master always has the current status, as long as the link is active. For counter-interrogation, you can specify how the counter values are to be transmitted. The transmission can be initiated either by the slave by selecting mode A or B, or by the master by selecting mode C or D. Once the counter has been freezed, that is to copy it from the current counter memory to a standby memory and timestamp it, it can be transmitted. This can be done spontaneously in modes A or D, so automatically after the freeze command, or only after the counter has been interrogated again in modes B and C. This also means that the same modes must be set for the master and slave, otherwise no counter values will be transmitted. For modes B, C and D, we can also activate a cyclic query, and if the master triggers the counter query in modes C and D, we also have the option of resetting the counter after the interrogation. Here, we can set which reset is expected from the slave when the reset telegram QRP is sent. 0 for not used, that means no reset is possible. 1 for a general reset, or 2. Resetting of all stored values with a timestamp. And the option Variable, Reset with Variable, which we assign in this field as a byte variable and which then contains one of the three reset options, 0, 1 or 2. In this line, we can specify a bool variable to trigger the reset. The parameters k, w, and t are the same as for the slave, but the master also has the parameter t0, which specifies how long the master waits for a response from the slave when establishing a connection. In this case, the master would wait 30 seconds for a TCP response from the slave, and if it does not receive a response within 30 seconds, it would retry to establish a connection. At the bottom, you can configure how commands are to be executed. Firstly, whether commands are executed directly or whether a command has to be selected first. If we now insert a single command, we have the SCS field for the actual command value. The trigger variable for execution is specified in the field below. It is important to note that the positive edge of the variable is required for execution. A change from false to true must take place. If we now switch to the select and execute option, we can also specify the variable for the preselection, for which we also need the positive edge. In gateway applications where commands are passed from the slave side to the master side, it is therefore always necessary to ensure that the positive edge is also present. As this can involve a considerable amount of programming, there is the option of direct execution on value change, in which case variables can simply be mapped from the slave to the master in order to pass them through directly. This is explained in more detail in the video Gateway Applications in Telecontrol. In the advanced settings, we have the option for the master to store the received data in a SQLite database by assigning the storage locations here, either in the controller's RAM or on an SD card. The maximum number of records to be stored is specified in the field behind this. If this limit is exceeded by 10%, the oldest records are deleted. The fault records of 103 protection devices can also be saved as a comtrade file. Create data points. The parameterization of the master is now complete and data points can be created. The direction of the commands and messages is now, of course, the opposite to that of the slave. As the master, we receive messages and send commands. If we look at the individual message, we again have the general settings with type, comment, and object address in the top field. Below this is the field for the actual message. Here we create a bool variable. We now use WinPP to simulate a slave and send a spontaneous message from it that door contact 1, xdoor 1, has been triggered and the variable in the master changes to true. In the telegram, we see that the IV bit is set. To be able to analyze this in the master, we create a variable for the IV bit in the quality information area. If we now send door contact 1 again, the variable for the IV bit will also be set. In the bottom area, transmission information, we can create a word variable in which the number of messages received is counted, in order to use this value in the application or to create analysis with it. If we now use WinPP to send the door contact message a few times, we can see how the value increases. Similarly, we can create a measured value and assign it to a real or integer variable, depending on whether the measured value is a scaled, normalized, or a floating point number. For commands, the master expects feedback from the slave that the command has been executed. This procedure is defined. The command is sent by the master with activation COT6. The slave confirms receipt with confirmation COT7. The slave sends the field level feedback that the command has been successfully executed with COT11 and terminates the command with activation termination COT10. In the status and event information area, we can create a byte variable to analyze where we are in the process. If the command is successfully transmitted, the variable will increment from 0, idle, to 4, done. Below this, we can create a byte variable to analyze the causes of the transmission. This is followed by the actual command variable and the execution time, whether the command is to be sent as a default, short, long, or continuous command. And then, as already discussed, the variables for select, execute, and cancel. The double command, again, contains two bool variables, usually one for on and one for off, and the setPoint command for setPoint transmission, which then sends a real or integer variable depending on the TI. Export and import of data points. Several substations can be connected to one master. It is often the case that several substations are connected to one master and that they are all structured in the same way. To avoid having to create all the data points for each station individually, it is possible to export all the data points of a station address to a CSV file and then import them into the new station address. All data points will be transferred, as well as the variable names, which now need to be changed. It may be helpful at this point to edit the CSV file directly before importing. When you open it, such a block is always a data point. Here is the type identifier, here is the object address, and here are the variables, one for the single message and one for the IV bit. The variable names we have assigned are also assigned to the abbreviations at the bottom of the table. We can now edit, save, and import these accordingly. The new variable name can either be changed here in the assignment table or directly in the data point block. This gives us the correct variable names directly in the new substation. Of course, this also works with the object addresses, comments, and so on. Serial master 101. Let us now take a look at the master 101, starting with balanced communication. With balanced communication, both participants, master and slave, are able to send, so a spontaneous message can be sent directly by the slave and is not requested by the master through cyclic polling. This also explains why we can only select RS-232 here and RS-422 from COM2 onwards, as only these two transmission types support simultaneous sending and receiving. Next are the baud rate, parity, and stop bits. At the top are the view options. Compared to the slave, the response delay time and the cycle time link layer have been added to the parameters. The response delay time is the time the master waits for a response from the slave. The cycle time link layer can be used to specify how often the test telegram should be sent to test the connection. And here how a telegram is structured, so how many bytes are used to represent the RSDU address, or whether the reason for the transmission is transmitted with the source address, in which case an additional byte is required or without. It is important that these parameters are set the same for master and slave. Otherwise, the telegrams will have no meaningful content. The settings for the slave connection are then almost identical to those for the 104 protocol. If we now look at unbalanced communication, the call interval is added at this point. In unbalanced communication, the slave is polled cyclically to see if it has anything to report. This method, known as polling, allows more than two participants to be connected, unlike symmetric communication. How often this happens per second is determined by the polling interval, that is the call interval. The default is 200 milliseconds. However, the polling interval should not be less than 100 milliseconds. Otherwise, collisions may occur in the subsequent process. The general master settings for unbalanced communication are almost identical to the balanced master, except of course that the field for the test telegram is omitted, as the communication is constantly checked by polling. Serial master 103. The 103 protocol is specifically designed to connect protection devices and therefore has more limited options. This is reflected in the general settings and in the settings for the slave connection. As protection devices are often set up in a line structure, it has become established that the link address and the SDU address are assigned equal. If further slave connections are added, the link address and the SDU address would always be assigned equal. This practice has become so widespread that in some cases only one address is documented. If we now look at the data points, we can see that there are far fewer to create than with the other protocols. For example, with bool data points, we only find the double point information in the signaling direction and the double command in the command direction. Some protection manufacturers refer to single point information or single commands at this point in their documentation. This means a double point information or a double command where only the first bit is used. The messages that a protection device can send and the commands that it can process can be found in the technical documentation of the protection device. Here we have such a list, and here we find the double command, enable recloser, and disable recloser. Further up, we find the acknowledgement, auto recloser active. We now want to create these two data points in the Telecontrol configurator by first creating the double command. The type identifier is 20, and we copy the comment from the list. Instead of the object address, we have to enter the identification. The first digit in protocol 103 is the same as the type identifier, which has been automatically taken over here and is therefore grayed out. The next digit is the function, which here is 160. In the lower information window, we find the possible functions. 160 is an overcurrent protection. The last digit is the information number. Then we assign variables, one for on and one for off. Then we can choose whether the execution is to take place directly with the value change of the variable or whether this is to be triggered by another variable. And again, we have the status message telling us where we are in the command sequence. As already mentioned, the master expects an answer to a command, which we can add with this button. In our case, the response is that the auto-recloser is active. We adopt the comment and the identification. And here we have the case that the manufacturer of the protection device only returns one bit, so we only assign a variable for DPI 0. Here, we can specify a variable in which we will have the timestamp in the form of CP32, hour, minute, millisecond. In the same way, we can create a single measured value with a real-time measured value. The data point next to it is also interesting, measured value, which allows up to 18 measured values to be recorded simultaneously. In the protection device manufacturer's list, under measured values, we find the following list: 3 measurements of the phase currents, 3 measurements of the voltage of the 3 phases, the active power, the reactive power, and the frequency. Further on in the technical documentation, we also find a note that these measurements are scaled to 120%, which we need to set under signal processing. A measured value package of 9 measured values, which we create here and to which we assign variables. This concludes the IEC 6870 master tutorial. Please use the title markers to jump to the relevant sections, give us a thumb up, and contact the WAGO support if you have any questions.